So we're here today to talk about the Yamaha XSR 700. A bike that I rode 2 years ago in Sardinia on the press launch. I absolutely loved it, all the other journos loved it. It's a little 689cc parallel twin, about 75 horsepower, something like that. Yamaha made a really big effort to reduce the weight on this bike, and it's a nimble, light bike, great fun to ride. Bit of a wheelie machine as well, but I'm shit at wheelies, so I have to take other people's word for that. But the main thing I liked about this bike is how easy it is to take bits off. They've thought about it. Pillion pegs, mounts, just unbolt and you're done with them. Seat comes off, tools here, four bolts, this whole loop comes off. So you don't need to have a customizer go and do you a loop tail if that's what you're after. It's inexpensive, good fun to ride, and sort of looks all right. There are some changes that I'd like to make and have made, because I think that the front end is a bit heavy and cumbersome, and the rear, even though Yamaha designers have tried, it's just all a bit of sort of homologated regulatory mess at the back, and I think it could be a lot better. So we're going to talk about the JVB Super 7. So this is my bike, the JVB Super 7. When I was in Sardinia, Jens gave me the keys to his original Super 7 and let me have a blat down the road once everyone had gone back to the hotel, and I had an absolute blast and thought, I've got to have one of these. So Yamaha did me a deal on a bike, bought the bike, spoke to Jens about a kit and started fitting it. The main thing people will notice with the kit is this sort of fairly synonymous with JVB's range, this headlight arrangement, which he's fitted to various XSRs, MTs. Back in the day, sort of 10 years ago, he was putting similar things on Ducatis, Monsters. So you get the kit in either bit parts. So if you can't afford the whole thing in one go, you can just order a headlight one day and some other bits another. But predominantly, the front end is the bit that I think that really changes this bike. You remember from the stock bike, it's all a bit gawky and sticky out. So with the JVB kit, you get this fiberglass mudguard, these really burly gaiters, stanchion shrouds, the headlight, which I've just mentioned, you know, laser cut, proper CNC bent bracket. So when you buy the kit, it's not like you have to go into the garage and start cutting stuff. You open it and it's like really smart IKEA. Everything's listed out in a Germanic way, as you'd imagine. And you can attack one piece at a time. So you think, oh, this weekend I haven't got much time, I'll do the mudguard and the headlight. Then another evening you might do something else. So they make it really easy. And I say it's all in sort of vacuum form packs with instructions, everything. And it's probably unfair to say IKEA because it's much, much easier than IKEA. In fact, Jens, if you're listening, you should do some work for IKEA and get their flat pack stuff better. So anyway, front headlight done. I painted this rad shroud just because this stock rad is silver and I think a bit ugly. On the new bikes now, they've actually addressed that and they've painted the whole thing black, which is good. The side panels, again, fiberglass. And fiberglass, you'd think, sounds like it's some sort of cheap knockoff, but it's not. What Jens does is he models everything in clay. He then has it all 3D scanned, and then he starts producing parts. And it's only when he's happy that the parts are going to fit perfectly to even the most, you know, butterfingered customer that he'll then release them. So, you know, these side panels as well replace the slightly clunky originals. And again, really nice stainless steel fixings, proper little anti-vibration washers that go behind. So it's not a cheap feeling kit. You also get LSL knurled foot pegs, and you also get a set of bar clamps which are lower than stock. Now these are the stock ones, because I prefer to have a slightly more upright riding position, so I left the stock ones in. But you get LSL bars, which are really nice. So you get the Renthal grips. You get these little indicators, which Jens has had these laser cut CNC bent brackets and shrouds and housings that mount just to the perch under there. Again, really nice and neat. And the tail is obviously much, much shorter, with a little LED strip that sits in there, and a much shorter seat. Now, if I had time, I'd unbolt this and show it to you, but underneath, it's just really nicely put together. it looks like a factory seat. On this bike I've also got the Olin's fully adjustable shock. Now that you can order direct from a Yamaha dealer. The bike handles really well straight out the crate, but the shock obviously helps. The main thing with these XSRs though is the front end, as standard, is a little bit squashy. So I've got Olin's preload adjusters with a slightly stiffer spring, different spacer in. Again, that comes as a kit from Olin's, which you can buy from your Yamaha dealer. And together with the shock and the fork springs, it just makes it a much taller ride. I've got Pirelli Diablo Coursers on there as well, which, as you can see, I haven't even tested. I've sort of done 10 miles down the road on them. I've just run out of time to ride on my bikes. But perhaps the biggest improvement visually and for the sound is this SC Project pipe. Really unleashes that thumpy, throaty note from the flat plane crank engine. So the acoustics are a bit rubbish in here, so it probably sound crap, but. Just a bit better than the stock one. Now this is, say, from SC Project. It's really nicely put together. There's some robotic welding, there's some hand welding, and you can barely tell the difference between the two. And all of the fittings are just lovely. They're just slipping in and out. Lovely interference fit. Top quality item. There's no wonder that MotoGP, World Superbike teams used SC Project. It's really nice. I've also fitted these Motor Gadget Emblaze pins because where the original indicators are mounted, I found that I was sort of knocking them and banging them and snapping them off. The other thing I would probably do is tidy up around here. Obviously, as a manufacturer, you have to have a proper fluid reservoir, but I'd get rid of that, hide it down in here somewhere, just maybe a bit of tube, and or just use this stock tube and cap it off, and work out some way of tidying all that arrangement up in here. So in a nutshell, that's the JVB Super 7 kit, which anyone out there can buy and fit to their XSR 700. He does also do kits for the MT as well, which is a more sort of scrambly one. Really like that one. But apart from that, I wouldn't do a huge amount to it other than ride it. And that is the problem with this bike. I've not had a chance to ride it, and winter on the way, I'm probably not going to have a chance to ride it. I don't want to spoil a nearly new motorcycle. So this one is for sale on the Bike Shed Classifieds. It's in the shop as well. So if someone fancies themselves a bit of a bargain on a pre-Christmas toy, give me a shout, ross@thebikeshed.cc. And I'm waffling like fuck now.